Good afternoon, everyone. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me once again. If you're not a follower, please follow. Here we have a live cam view there at Old Faithful Yellowstone National Park. And they're currently looking at beehive, and it looks a little dirty, don't it? Yeah, maybe they'll move it in a few minutes. And give you an idea how big it is. There's the boardwalk up behind. The earthquake swarm is continuing there in the Madison River area. We have 16 earthquakes within the last 24 hours. Here you can see we got the Madison River. The largest earthquake in the last 24 hours was supposedly a 1.9, but it was actually a little bit higher, a magnitude 2. 7 miles in depth, so this is coming up from the plume. From the bottom of the upper magma chamber, here we got the lower magma chamber, so it's coming up from, see these two little areas? And it's probably coming in through the Snake River Plateau, yeah, feeding into this system. Here you can see the upper magma chamber. Now that extends all the way down to about 10 miles in depth. So the magma's coming up here from the magma reserve, coming up into the upper magma chamber. And we know that because of the depth that they have listed here in miles. Most recent they got reported here is at 1606 universal time. Supposedly a 0.3, but this one's shallower, 4.6 miles. There's the 1.9. 7.2 miles, etc. That's all they got listed. 16 within the last 24 hours. And I downloaded three different monitors. This one here is the borehole for the Madison River area. I've covered this. It's a very deep well under the ground, about 600 feet that they drilled down and put in the monitors. This one here is at Maple Creek. That has the best signature. And this one here is Lake Butte. Lake Butte, it didn't really show up that well there. So here we have the signature of what they're saying is 1.9, and you can see down there below, it actually is probably a 2.4 or greater. And look at the magma that came in during that earthquake. Wow. Now I've talked about how we got pockets of melted rock, underneath the ground where people are walking, only about 600 feet below where people are walking. Now there is 22 earthquakes marked in red here on this monitor. USGS is only reporting 16 of them. When they're marked in red, it means the computer picked it up, sends a text message to probably there, the University of Utah, and they're supposed to review it and figure out how big the earthquake was. This one here at 1606 is the last reported earthquake by USGS. They say it is a magnitude 0.3, but I come up with a magnitude, let's go down here, 1.58. And we'll look at its seismic signature. There you go. 1.58. There is a smaller one afterwards, right there, but it's not marked in red. And this is when I pulled the files just a little while ago. And they've had high winds and snow there the last couple days at Yellowstone. It's now currently heading across the plains of the United States, the mid, like South Dakota, Illinois, and Missouri. And they'll probably claim that these earthquakes are caused by the water going down into the system. But they're way too deep. You can see that they're way too deep. Here we have one of the tilt meters. This is for the Norris Geyser Basin where they have the camera. They're measuring which direction that it rises up. And this goes back to March of the 15th. And you can see we got steady increase. And I reported that. And it looks like the ground is rising going towards the north. And that makes sense because that's the direction that the volcano, the caldera, is slowly moving. Now this is for the last 7 days. Lots of dots means lots of earthquakes. And here we have the direction of the uplift that's been going on for the last 30 days. Yeah, each dot would be indication of an earthquake that caused some changes for the ground either to rise up or to drop down. In this case, it's rising up. And here we have it going back to 2014. X would be north and Y would be east. Yeah, it looks like we got more uplift there for the Y monitor than the X monitor. Here we have it for the Madison River area where the current earthquake swarm is going on. Yep, it's definitely rising up. And yeah, going up probably a little northwest a little bit. And then the last several years, going back to 2011. Now take a look at it down here. Yeah, it's been really rising since 2019. And many of you that have been following me remember that in 2019, yeah, Steamboat Geyser was more active, new springs erupted, all kinds of changes happened back then. Here we have the tilt for Grant, which is at the southwest end of Yellowstone Lake. And yeah, lots of dots means lots of activity. You can see it's been going up. Now that one, the tilt for the lake, we know the lake is tilting, going towards now northwest. This is what the monitor was showing when I pulled the data for the borehole 207. And let's make it bigger. Yeah, these are volcanic tremors. Magma on the move. Let's go down here. Drum beats. There hasn't been a lot of drum beats today, but we do have them right here about every 5 seconds, it looks like. Let me pull this over. That's when you got a blockage for where the magma is coming up through a channel, a dike intrusion, a lava tube, and it's blocked. It's got to melt it. It melts it and then shoots through, melts it about every 5 seconds. And as you know, any volcano can erupt within 10 minutes with no warning at all. I hope many of you watched my video about what's going on with the wildlife there in Yellowstone. They're starving and finding a new source of food, which happens to be people. Now, this is the monitor for Lake Butte, which is over on the northeast side of Yellowstone Lake. And I've talked about the crack. Yeah, look at that. That's down there at the bottom of the lake where the magma is trying to come up. And it's got a cap of rhyolite there. And these are their actual scientific term, blobs of magma that was coming into the system. And this is what was going on. Now that's an interrupt. Let me pull it over. Look at that. Pocket of melt and the line of melt. Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that before. And let's jump around to some of these other blobs of magma. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let's go over here to this one, and that one, and that one, and we got one down over here. All right, and we'll come back up over here. Oops. And we'll make this bigger. Oh, they got rounded tops. Rounded tops, yep. Definitely magma trying to come up there at Yellowstone Lake. Now, many of you who have followed me over the years will remember when I covered Mary's Bay, when that was created and how it caused a tsunami there at the lake, threw out rocks, yeah, a long ways away, threw out the water, a long ways away. The rock was evidently shot up over a mile into the air, and the tsunami stretched out from Yellowstone, about 3 miles in distance. the hydrothermal explosion that created Mary's Bay stretches more than 1 mile across. It may have displaced over 77 million cubic feet of water. And for some reason, the geologist, Lisa Morgan, I believe her name is, thinks there was at least two big waves before the eruption of Mary's Bay. Evidence of those waves have been found more than 3 miles north of Yellowstone Lake's edge, she said. The explosive column may have reached more than a mile into the air and spread debris across some 18 square miles, she said. And it's gearing up for another eruption there at Yellowstone Lake. Going to Mary's Bay, this here is the location where that explosion and subsequent tsunami occurred. Up over here is the Yellowstone River. Because of the uplift here, it's kind of blocking off the flow of the water coming out of the lake. That eruption happened only about 13,800 years ago. And I got where I believe that crack is, where the magma's trying to come up again. And I also have drawn out areas that's under the lake, hydrothermal vents. There's deep canyons here in the lake, about 390 feet deep. Over here on the right, that is Lake Butte. That's where the one monitor comes from. Over here, we have another area that's been inflating, rising up. Oh, good. They moved the camera finally. This mountain here, that is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Yellowstone has two resurgent domes. Most volcanoes only have one. You know, the cone that comes up in the center of a volcano. But Yellowstone is so big, it's got two. And we're looking at, this is the Firehole River that runs through here. Let me move this over a little bit. And you can see all the snow. And then the heat from under the ground has melted that snow. But they've been having about a week's worth of snow that's going on. And let me pull it down a little bit and see the water from all that melted snow down over here. And of course, let's see, let me pull it up. You don't really got too much of a view of the dead trees, but this line of trees dying from the gases coming up. There's a spring up over here. And of course, in my video I did about the grizzlies and the threat of grizzlies to people, they got a fungus called rust that's been attacking the pine trees. And then they got the beetles, because they're weakened, have been killing off the trees. And the bears, the pine nuts, one of their main sources of food is diminished, a lot, along with the fish. So that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared. Especially now with inflation telling us it's 8.5%. It's more like 50% or higher. And we got some severe weather coming in today and tonight. So you should always be prepared for whatever may be thrown at us. Thank you for your support. I'm on Patreon if you wish to support my work. Thank you very much to all of you that do support me. Thank you very much for following me. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.